Let's get started with Natillion Connect. So I guess that you already have a Natillion account for any Natillion service. And if you haven't signed up yet for an account, this would be the time to pause the video and sign up for an account. We just take it from here and go to any Natillion service, and we will check for data that we have available to play around a little with the Natillion Connect API. So now let's say you don't have any data in your freshly created Natillion account. I will show you now how you select your first Natillion service and as well how to get some demo data populated into your account. Let's go to the landing page of natillion.anders.com. And don't be bothered that we are using the staging environment here for Natillion. You can do all the steps that we're showing as well in the productive environment. I signed up for a Natillion value application because this fits greatly to this demonstration right now, as we want to work with measurement values. Inside here, you can see a little dashboard collected. And in the all objects view, we can see all elements of my little plant here. Now let's say you want to add the demo data here to your account. Just go to your profile and scroll down to demo data and just flip the toggle here. And now when you're going back to your value application, you see that we have some more simulated values here. And in all objects, you can see Natillion demo data. So with this data, you can easily work and get started with the Natillion API. For reference, I will just put to my clipboard a certain asset ID of this water tank. We got the asset, the FWR30 micropilot, connected to it, the smart radar. So when we go to the asset view right here, then we can find the asset ID in the URL at the very end after the last slash. Maybe you can just save that for reference for later. So now we want to go to the developer.anders.com website. And from that website, you will find all information around the Natillion Connect offering. And below support, you will find the link to the interactive API documentation. We will work in the staging documentation right now, as explained before. And here I'm able to use my Natillion API key and login credentials. So now maybe you don't have your API key yet. So I'll show you how you can get your first Natillion API key. Just go back to Natillion, go to your profile, and in subscriptions, you will find Natillion Services and Natillion Connect. You can create a new subscription. You can create a new subscription by clicking on Create. You will see all the tiered offering here. And the left one, the basic, is for free. And just check what application fits to you. And we will just work with the basic subscription right here. We already have a subscription. Below the subscriptions, you can find the API keys, and I will use the latest API key here that I just created with clicking on Create once again. Remember that when you create an API key, there is basic or OAuth authentication. For the basic authentication, we just need the API key and your login credentials. For OAuth, this is a little for more complex applications which require more secureness, and we will just work for our tryout with the basic authentications. So I got this API key copied to my clipboard and will return to the API documentation, put in the API key, and my login credentials are already there, saved in the browser. So now you can see in section all the endpoints of the Natillion API, everything we can work with. And once you tap on one of those elements, you can see the RESTful commands that you can work with. Get, post, patch, and delete. So with get, we can call some information from our demo data right now, or let's start just with a very simple request of getting all our assets in one list. So we select get assets, and now try out. This is for the authentication necessary. Now we could specify with these parameters our requests a little bit, for example, by manufacturer or by a certain time frame, but we keep it as a very general request and execute it. And now below here, we see with the response code 200, which is okay, our list of assets in the JavaScript object notation format. We can see as well the related notes, documents, and further references to all of these assets. With the second example, let's have a look at measurement values. So we will go down to the section values below, and the first entry is get asset, asset ID, and values. So this means we will have to work with a certain asset ID, and we got a certain asset ID already saved in our clipboard, or probably just in our notes. So just go to your notes and take one of the asset IDs that you want to know values about it. So this is still the same here, and hit execute. Now as well, response 200, everything is okay. We can see the values of the FWR30 from our demo units. So we can as well see the battery state, the distance, the unit, and the level here is 54 right now. So let's compare this to our front-end application and let's go to value. And you can see the water tank one with its value, it's 54%. So this is just a little example on working with the Natillion API, and you can find further information in the next video clips.